Gosh, it's Brock. Some shit's about to go down. Title looks horrible on him, but hey, that's the red blood title. Looks horrible on anyone. Still looks horrible on him, but whatever.
Ladies and gentlemen, my
name is Paul Heyman.
And I am the advocate for the reigning, defending, Undisputed Universal Champion,
Brock Lesnar.
A little something different tonight. My client has authorized me to be a little personal this evening and reveal to you a bedtime story that Brock tells his children that I tell my children at night. And it goes a little something like this. Once upon a time, there was a man who fancied himself a superhero. And this superhero represented all the things in life that we as a society should stand up and rebel against. You know, honor, dignity, honesty,
honesty?
Oh, I don't know, family, tradition. Oh man, I'm gonna vomit in my own mouth. Well, one day this superhero took his spear and his jackhammer and decided to go into town. And this superhero's name was Goldberg. And
Dad, this story sucks.
As the baddest dude in the village. All the villagers would run around going, oh no, that's Goldberg. He's a bad man. So this bad Goldberg. Oh, well, that is the best part. Because, you see, once Goldberg took everything away from the villagers, like, I don't know what the top of my head, the Universal title? Then Goldberg took a left turn and took an ultimate
the Suplex City
through the village of South Central Suplex City.
Oh, it's in South Central?
Suplex City.
It's specific now?
Where honor and valor and dignity and honesty and family and tradition are not respected. And what happened? What happened to our superhero when he went to Suplex City? Well, our superhero got his ass kicked by the Beast.
You're 2-2 now, I think.
Now, for all the little
kids I don't know anymore.
Right now being tucked into bed, I don't want you to worry.
You only got one win?
This fairy tale does have
I think.
Happily ever after. And ladies and gentlemen, and my children too, that happily ever after is... You won't be seeing Bill Goldberg around here anymore! So, yes, thank you, Taker, and yes, thank you, Brock! Now, ladies and gentlemen, that leaves us in a situation where my client, Brock Lesnar, is looking for a new challenge.
Oh, shit! Who's coming out?
Challenger.
This is going to be good. Someone up to the level of Brock. Who's it going to be? Only person I can think of is Shinsuke. That's the only person I can think of is Shinsuke.
So, let's go down the list. Can you imagine after his victory over Triple H last night, Seth Rollins versus Brock?
No, we don't want to see that. Someone new.
You know what?
Could it be? That's Shinsuke. That's the only one I can think of right now.
Can you imagine after his spectacular return, Matt Hardy versus Brock?
No. Maybe if it was broken Matt Hardy, not just regular Matt Hardy.
Versus Brock Lesnar. Hey, I can imagine both Hardys versus Brock Lesnar.
You will make them obsolete.
Please. Accept this into your hearts. Brock Lesnar is not going to be one of these champions that just takes a bunch of selfies with the title and he cherishes and savors every single moment that he has the championship, that he knows time is fleeting, that he knows he won't reign as champion forever. Ladies and gentlemen, Brock Lesnar is the disruptor of the status quo, which is why it's time here and now to talk about the 2023 and 2.
Hey now.
Because history demands those two go one-on-one to determine who's yard.
Really? Roman versus Brock? Get the fuck out of here.
Because if you haven't heard the news, if you're not on your phones this evening, psst, we're out here talking about you, Roman Reigns. Roman Reigns, who's spending the whole night running around the locker room, barking around orders like he's the big dog in WWE.
Oh yeah, Balor. I forgot about Balor. We're really going with this?
Then
Roman versus Brock?
Lesnar is animal cruelty. So my client, before we came out, authorized me to also say this. It's time to give the Monday Night Raw after WrestleMania crowd something they will never forget.
What's gonna happen? Let's see this. Something's about to go down.
It's time to deliver something special. It's time to deliver that one-on-one. And why wait forever? Why not do something right here? Right now!
Oh, they're going with Roman, aren't they?
Two
Braun! Really, Braun? It just got worse.
About to happen, all right. The mountain among men, Braun Strowman marching down to the ring. Lesnar called out the big dog and got a monster instead. That monster is about to come face to face with a...
Braun's gonna talk. Oh, he's been looking for that competition. This actually makes sense, though. Holy shit, he's taller than him. Never realized how small Brock was. Good lord.
I see Roman Reigns has your attention. When I'm finished with Roman Reigns, maybe I'll have yours. Because Brock Lesnar, you damn sure got my attention.
Ooh, you done pushed him, son. You can't do that, son. Boy, who do you think you are? Cross the line. Braun will cross the line.
See this?
Cross the line. Do it. Damn it, man. Really? Really?
See though, Lesnar and Strowman. Braun wants to finish off Roman Reigns first, and then turn his attention to the Beast Incarnate.
So Braun, we're setting up a Braun versus Brock fight, huh?
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome my guest at this time, Chris Jericho.
Hey.
Chris, in 4 weeks at Payback, you'll get your rematch
with
Kevin Owens for the United
States Championship. He has a rematch already?
But first things first, tonight, you're teaming up with Seth Rollins to take on Owens and Samoa Joe in a tag team match.
Let's talk about tonight. The Raw after WrestleMania, one of my favorite nights of the year, with an arena filled with the most raucous, intense, hilarious, entertaining, electric crowds the entire year here right now tonight. And remember, Beach Ball Mania is running wild, brother! That's right. You see, this is my crowd, my pals, my buddies from Mexico, the amigos of Jericho. From Japan, the Tomodachis of Jericho. From France, mes amis de Jericho, all the way to the UK, the mates of Jericho. All across the 50 states, Canada, right here tonight, they're the friends of Jericho.
Are we making another thing now?
On, man.
The Friends of Jericho? Is that the next thing that he's gonna do?
So this is the perfect place for me tonight. To start getting my revenge on that stupid idiot Kevin Owens for beating me last night at WrestleMania for the United States Championship. And I'm gonna start with the first piece of my revenge, the tip of Kevin Owens' finger. Because it was the tip of Kevin Owens' finger.
Just a tip.
That allowed him to beat me at WrestleMania last night after I hit him with a crushing codebreaker, smashing his face right into this knee. One, said the referee. Two, tip of his finger stopped the three count. By the hair of his chinny chin chin, by the skin of his teeth, in the blink of an eye, he was able to not get beaten by the tip of his finger. But you know what happens? You know what happens? Tip of Kevin Owens' finger.
He just made the list.
You know what happens when you help Kevin Owens beat Chris Jericho at WrestleMania?
Do it, man.
Tip of Kevin Owens' finger. You just made the list! And I'm gonna take that tip of his finger and I'm gonna...
Oh, shit! Friends, no more. Hey, Joe.
The Destroyer, Samoa Joe, and the United States Champion. Laying down the beating on Jericho.
Oh, right for the table.
Oh, no.
Damn.
Hey, Owens, come on, that's enough now. Come on, guys.
I'm so serial, guys. Enough of that shit, guys. I'm so serial.
Let's get it out, guys. Come on. That's enough. Hey, come on, guys. That's it.
Come on, guys. I'm so serial.
WWE Supercard sponsors WWE.